Hello, ladies and gents. This is Radar. I already did his bath, only because it's really humid outside right now, and I'm doing my best to just kind of get through. And I kind of also forgot to start the live, but I'm here now, and we're going to be doing just a silhouette trim on Radar today, okay? Oh, Radar. He is a little bit more one of my, like, sensitive ones. So he likes to tense up a lot, and he likes to also move his butt away the whole time. But that's okay, we work with him. I know. Oh, there's a mat right there. I got it, we're good. Good boy, Radar. I know about this. I'm not doing an all-over haircut, I'm really just doing a silhouette trim. I am going to brush them out pretty thoroughly right off the bat. In a lot of my videos, you'll see that I don't necessarily brush out right off the bat. It depends on what I'm doing with the dog. If I'm doing an all-over, like free all-over, taking it really short with my clipper back, there's no reason to brush out right before. But if I'm doing a longer cut, then yes, I'll brush out very thoroughly before. And I just don't want to have to brush out after I'm done, because again, he's one of my more, like, he gets a little bit stressed a little more easily. So I try to just make this as quick of an appointment as possible. He's still very good. He just likes to question what I'm doing the whole time. You'll also see me probably talk to somebody at some point in the video. That's because I'm expecting some food to be delivered to me. Okay, I'm using a 40 with my clipper back on the paw pack. He is a ranch dog, so you want to get his paws and everything trimmed up as much as possible so that he can run around and not drag dirt inside the house. So what I'm doing is I'm going around each every paw pad right here, and I'm actually vacuuming and clipper backing right around it. That's also a little handy trick if you're wanting to do short teddy bear feet. That's going to keep it nice and round right off the bat for you. Okay, here we go. You're gonna see me pull on him a lot, and it's because he does try to move away the whole time. He gives me a lot of resistance. I promise you, I'm not hurting him when I pull him back over towards me. That resistance is kind of what makes it look a little bit more, like, fierce than it actually is. Okay, let's keep her in hand. Come on. Give me the booty. Give me the booty. He is punching that booty. Come here. Radar. Come here. Get it. I'm using my clipper back to get it because it makes it a little difficult, so it's easier if I have the hair sucked up into the blade. Come here. I'm grabbing the penis area and I'm pinching it, and then I'm letting my clipper back suck up that hair into my pen blade while making sure that his actual genital doesn't go into the clipper back and cause the stress.
Did that do that?
Alright, I'm going to do something a little different on him today. Normally I hand scissor his corgi butt, but I've got a big wide guard comb that I want to try out. Come here. So we're going to try it out. This is my longest one. It's a 1 1/4. Or 1 1/2. And yes, I'll scissor it all into submission. I'm just kind of trying it out and seeing how it works. Okay. Not bad. It's not a guard comb I'm going to use very often. But it's not bad. Okay, I'm going to scissor the rest of the butt into submission. I don't know why I always say it like that, but I do. Radar. Radar. I need your butt. Radar. Radar. We need to talk about it. I need your butt. And I need you to stop twisting. So I'm going to double leash you so you stop twisting around like a crazy person, okay? I don't want to double leash you, but I have to. I'm just trying to get your butt done. This is my Utsumi comb that my friend Martina at Barton Beautiful got me. It was very pleasant of her. Doesn't have testicles, so I'm going to be scissoring here and it's going to look super dangerous, but guys, there's a lot of room under there. I promise you. The beautiful thing about this Utsumi comb is that it has a nice little curve to it, you see? And so it really picks up and pulls out that fur. Mom likes a heart-shaped corgi butt, so in a minute after I'm done evening it out from what I did with the guard comb, I'm going to put his legs together and kind of make it more a little bit of a heart shape. I am taking his butt just a tad bit shorter than I normally go, only because he loves to be outside. And it's getting, he's going to be outside more often because the cold is finally fading a little bit. Dad is raising some ducks, and he's been chasing those ducks. So I want him to, if he gets inside the pond or whatever, he doesn't end up getting super dirty or making it very difficult just a tad shorter. Uber Eats order, so bear with me. Pause, I'm getting my food. Radar, who's here?
Stop, you gotta chill. Don't. Okay, I should have said that. I got you excited.
Hey, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Have a good day. Alright, let's continue. Got myself some coffee. Don't worry, guys, I'm literally right here. He's not that far from me. I'm just abandoning Radar on the table and saying good luck. Oh, but I got some boba tea. That's gonna make my day so much better. Thank you to San Poke. I'm using my curves at this point because I'm just shaping. I'm not actually pressing too close against his fur. And I'm really just wanting to scissor out any leftover long hairs. There you go. That's a cute butt, dude. You got a good looking butt. Going in the shape of a heart, like as if I'm doing the, like this part, that's what I'm doing in this area. Here we go, cute quirky butt. Cute quirky butt. Kind of such a good looking butt. Okay. Now I'm gonna chunker this long fur over here out. Chunker, scientific term, right? Okay. And then I'm gonna trim up his side. No, not. What I'm going to do. I really just go between the toes, scoop all that hair up, and then scissor and blend. Because I already did a pretty good amount of edging on his paws when I did that, when I did the clipper back. Chunkers. Turn a little bit this way, buddy. Good boy. least favorite. Sierra does her booty and she does her feet. Everything else is pretty chill. It's the booty and the feet that get you. Alright. The rest you can be released for, okay? Good job. Relax. Relax. That's my boy. Alright, so now I'm going to take my chunkers and I'm going to do right here when he stops climbing on me. Right here. Remember how much of a badass you have to be in this industry. It is not something that is easy or that anybody can do and do well. A lot of people think that they can just pick up a pair of clippers and boom, they're groomers. And man, the amount of work that really needs to go into this craft and the fact that you do it is amazing. You're amazing. We're all amazing.
Dear Theodosia, what to say to you? You have my eyes, you have your mother's name. When you came into the world, you cried, and it broke my heart. I'm dedicating every day to you. Domestic life was never quite.
Have a great day.